With the release of the iPhone 17 series and the launch of the new 40-watt dynamic power adapter priced at $39, discussions have surged around its support for the AVS protocol. Does the iPhone 17 support this new protocol? And is this charger necessary for faster charging? Let's break it down. AVS is an adjustable voltage output mechanism introduced by USBIF as part of the EPR in the USB 3.1 spec. Under the USB PD 3.0 released in 2017, the standard only supported fixed voltage levels in the PPS, which adjusts voltage from 5 to 20 volts with 20 millivolt steps and current adjustments in 50 milliamp steps. The USB PD 3.1, released in 2019, expanded this with EPR mode. This mode enables higher fixed voltage outputs of 28 volts, 36 volts, and 48 volts, while incorporating EPR AVS. It allows for fine voltage adjustments in the range of 15 to 48 volts with 100 millivolt steps. The latest USB PD 3.2 spec, released in 2024, expands the AVS to a standard power range of up to 100 watts. This version, referred to as SPR AVS, enables precise voltage adjustments within the 9 to 20 volts range, also with 100 millivolt step increments. The main differences between PD 3.0 PPS, PD 3.1 EPR AVS, and PD 3.2 SPR AVS lie in the voltage range, adjustment precision, application scenarios, and power delivery modes. During the PD 3.0 era, PPS was designed for mid to low power devices like smartphones. It allows tuning voltage in 20 millivolt steps and current in 50 milliamp steps within the 5 to 20 volts range, allowing efficient direct charging. With PD 3.1, the EPR mode and AVS protocol expanded power output to 15 to 48 volts and up to 240 watts. EPR AVS, designed for high-power devices like laptops, allows 100 millivolt voltage steps for stable, efficient high-voltage output and reduced conversion loss. The PD 3.2 spec extends AVS to the SPR range, forming PD 3.2 SPR AVS for devices under 100 watts, like tablets and phones. It retains fine voltage adjustment capability but narrows the voltage range to 9 to 20 volts. It is important to highlight that while PPS supports finer 20 millivolt steps on paper, real-world issues like cable loss, resistance, and voltage ripple typically exceed 20 millivolts, making its advantage theoretical rather than practical. More critically, PPS also suffers from a power cliff at low voltages. Current limits cause a sharp power drop, reducing fast charging efficiency. In contrast, AVS's 100 millivolt steps are precise enough for battery needs and resistant to noise. Its constant current design avoids PPS's power drop, delivering more stable, efficient charging. The AVS protocol operates as a real-time adjustable power channel. During PD communication, the device, sync, requests specific voltage and current values from the charger, source, via the CC signal. Once confirmed, the source enters AVS mode, allowing continuous voltage adjustment within its supported range. During operation, the sync then monitors voltage, current, power, and temperature, sending AVS adjust commands to fine-tune output in real time, giving the charger demand-responsive control. Internally, a digital control chip in the source adjusts the behavior of the DC-DC converter based on feedback signals, enabling millisecond-level voltage changes. As a result, the charging curve closely follows the real-time needs of the device, optimizing efficiency and thermal performance throughout the charging process. Apple's first 140-watt USB-C power adapter, launched in 2021 with the 16-inch MacBook Pro, supports the USB PD 3.1 EPR specification and features an AVS of 15 to 28 volts, with a maximum output power of 140 watts. This means that during charging, it can dynamically adjust up to 28 volts to meet laptop power needs. According to official information, it can charge a MacBook Pro to 50% in around 30 minutes. The new 40-watt dynamic power adapter supports USB PD 3.2 SPR AVS, offering 40 watts nominal and up to 60 watts peak output. It can adjust the output voltage within the 9 to 20 volts range in 100 millivolt steps. Thanks to the AVS, the charger can precisely control the output voltage to the ideal level based on the device's needs. This enhances efficiency and reduces heat generation. Based on the charging curves of the iPhone 17 series we tested, these models currently do not yet support the PD3.2 SPR AVS protocol. The iPhone 17 series is still to rely on the PD protocol. However, Apple may gradually enable support for the new protocol through OTA updates in the future. Instead of using proprietary standards, Apple adopts open USBIF protocols, avoiding ecosystem fragmentation and allowing third-party accessories to stay compatible, benefiting manufacturers and consumers alike. The deeper significance lies in how Apple, through the influence of the iPhone, is driving the entire industry toward a unified, efficient fast charging standard. SPR AVS fixes PPS's shortcomings and offers a balanced solution for future devices in speed, heat control, and compatibility. Besides the Apple 40-watt charger, Google's 67-watt dual port and several KandiSign models also support SPR AVS. Some data cables with built-in control chips can even enable chargers that originally do not support SPR AVS or even PPS protocols to become compatible with these standards. The PowerZKM003C tester, after updating to the latest firmware version, now detects PD3.2 and SPR AVS, making protocol checking easier. The introduction of the AVS protocol marks a smarter, more efficient era of USB PD charging. From the early PD3.0 PPS to PD3.1 EPR AVS, and now to the latest PD3.2 SPR AVS, voltage precision and stability have improved, allowing real-time fine-tuning and better energy efficiency. Unlike fixed-step charging, AVS enables dynamic power delivery, offering faster charging, less heat, and lower energy loss. Currently, Apple and Google have taken the lead in integrating AVS technology into their high-end chargers. Though the iPhone 17 doesn't yet support SPR AVS, its adoption signals the coming era of adaptive fast charging, shaping the future charging ecosystem.